Willkommen auf Österreich, home of the Wien Schnitzel, schnapps and amazing mountains like this. And today we're here to take a look at the EM5 Mk III from Olympus. So let's see what's in store.
So Olympus gave us a cool day's activities planned out, as you can see here. And we started off with a bit of a street walk, so we're going to have a little wander around the town of Kitzbühel, flash up a few shots, see what we can find to take photos of. But before we do any of that, let's have a little look and talk about the specs.
Okay, so here we are. We're in Kitzbühel, which is gorgeous, absolutely stunning. And we're playing with the EM5 Mk III. Quite a bit has changed, actually. 20 megapixel live MOS sensor, micro four thirds. It's now slightly redesigned on the body. So if we look here, you've got a little thumb grip on the back. You've got your housing, your ISO button. They've also just improved modes now on the mode dial. You've got the live composite and the live bulb and features like that, which is nice and handy because they're great features.
And now I'm ready.
So the autofocus, 121 points, but it's had a bit of an upgrade. As is the ISO, so it's the same range, but now it's supposedly two stops better. So you'll have a better low light performance when you're shooting with this in the dark. But there's things like a 50 megapixel high res mode, which is better than the previous 40 megapixels.
So in terms of stabilization, this actually does 5.5 stops in the body or 6.5 stops with a lens with Sync IS, which is a nice boost. And actually, not only is it good if you want to go with shooting in slower shutter speeds or low light, it's good for the movies. It has improved movie performance. So it does cinema 4K, 24 frames a second. It does 4K 30. And of course it does 1080 at 120. So it should be a pretty beastly little camera for video. It does have a flat mode. It doesn't have log though. But really, is this the kind of camera you're going to buy because it has login? Probably not. Oh, the light round here is gorgeous. Golden hour just coming in, and the colours, the autumn colours here are just... I mean, you can see for yourself. Maybe.
So having a little walk around Kitzbühel, it's just such a stunning place. It's that classical thing. We found this little church as well. Tried out low light focusing and the high ISO. It did a pretty good job, and we just got some shots around here, nice contrasty scenes, and it handled the contrast and the tones really well. But next up, it was time to get a little bit of elevation and go and take advantage of this gorgeous golden hour and find some really cool scenes to shoot.
So we're in a chairlift. We're going to the top of somewhere to take some sunset photos and test out some of the features. Obviously the dynamic range shouldn't be much of a surprise, but you've got the 50 megapixel high res shot that's going to stitch all the images together. That's going to be fun. And you've got the live bulb as well and the live composite. We won't be doing star trails or anything to worry about, but the live bulb might come in quite handy. We'll see how he goes. There's not any clouds or anything moving, but give it a bash, see what happens. Otherwise, I'm just going to enjoy the view because it's quite peaceful up here.
After jumping off and making an idiot of myself, which I'm not showing you here, we got these views, we got these cool log cabins, and it was time to take advantage and get a couple of shots.
So we made it to the top and we just had to play around, like I said, with the high resolution mode. I don't have a tripod, so I put it on the Pixie little tripod and shot some stuff off. Now, high resolution mode obviously shifts the center a little bit, takes a new photo each time, then stitches them together. And actually, it's really impressive. Zooming in on the back of the screen, everything looks crystal clear, really sharp. Have to wait till I get back to the monitor and have a look. But so far, it's a really nice looking file. And obviously, it's equivalent to a 50 megapixel file. Now on the rear, it's got the same familiar layout. So obviously, you're using the D-pad. And it is a nice D-pad to move around. Obviously, you've got the OK button in there, which takes you to the quick menu. You can just move around, change most of your settings on there. So at the moment, I'm pretty standard. I'm shooting in manual, I usually do. But we're going to switch over and see how it deals on aperture priority and see how the metering is. Let's give that a bash. Having a look around, it's set on center weighted metering, so it's actually doing a really good job. This is a really challenging scene as well, and it seems to be picking up a really nice mid-tone as well. So if you want to shoot in aperture or shutter priority, the metering system's actually really capable, so yay for you. So we've been and we've had dinner, we've had a couple of drinks, probably far too many to operate a camera. We're still giving it a bash, and again, the M5 Mk III is a massive shadow on my face. The M5 Mk III has the live composite mode, which is perfect for things like light trails, light painting, star trails, where it only exposes for the highlights and then adds them in. And that's what we're going to give a shot now. So I'm going to go off in a minute and try some light painting. We've got a little setup here with tripods and a couple of torches and see how it does. So wish me luck and I'll be back in a minute with the results. Here we go.
So you can see it stacks every individual highlight into a series of shots that comes out as one image, and it's a really cool effect. Now, I didn't manage to bagsee a tripod, so I was on the floor with a aps-c and my horizon was a bit skewed, but it is a really cool feature to have. So with a bit of sleep under our belts, it was time to get into these cool gondolas, which is a personal favourite, get to the top of the mountain in time for blue hour, sunrise, and just take advantage of some of the absolutely stunning scenery. Despite a couple of changes, the ergonomics are quintessentially Olympus, so it's a great camera if you're upgrading from an Olympus, and if you're coming from a different system, it's so easy to pick up.
So, compared to the Mk II, the Mk III feels like a new camera with so many advancements. You've got, obviously, the 20 megapixel sensor, which is up from the 16 megapixel sensor. You've got 4K video and cinema 4K as well at 24 frames a second, and a little play, it looks pretty crispy. You've obviously got the high res mode that's up from 40 megapixels, it's now 50 megapixels, and I've been playing with it and it's looking phenomenal, I have to say. Makes a massive difference as well. The autofocus is also up, so it's now 121 points, which brings it in line with the Mk I and the EM1X. The autofocus actually hasn't let me down so far, even shooting in the low light conditions, waiting for sunrise, and I'm shooting against sunrise as well. It's done a really good job. The face tracking is obviously in their face and eye priority, so that's an ugly shot with the car behind me. Sorry, I don't know why I turned around. Let's look at that again. I think they've made some really good inroads. The EM1X had a phenomenal system, especially with the recognition stuff. So, fingers crossed, it's going to be on the same level, if not pretty damn close. Anyway, this is really cold, so I'm going to put some gloves on and bugger off.
So here's one of the shots I took with high res, and if we zoom in, you can actually see there's so much clarity in the file. It's the equivalent of 50 megapixels. And it really does make a difference. In fact, zooming into the top of here, you can make out this individual hut and the paint scheme. Now that is impressive. Anyway, after a full day, it was time to make our way back down, and we came across this stunning lake, so it was time for a couple of reflection shots, including Olympus's very own paraglider, which was actually a really cool touch. Something else they put on for us was a couple of mountain bikers so we could test out some of the continuous autofocus, and I managed to get a couple of frames off there. Pretty cool actually, it worked pretty well. I'm going to have to reserve judgment till I do a proper review though, but initially pretty impressive. And finally I got to play with a couple of models, well, actually one model. I only had 3 minutes, squeezed off a couple of shots. Happy to report the face detection worked really well, and I wound up with a couple of keepers. So all in all, that is our quick first look at the Olympus OMD EM5 Mk III. And yeah, it looks like it's shaping up to be a really good travel camera. It's really capable, and it is a huge step up from the last version. So guys, that's all from us. If you enjoyed this, leave a like, subscribe, and feel free to drop a comment down below and let us know what you think of the EM5 Mk III.